I am very proud of my album collection. Ever since I was a kid, I wanted to buy albums because there were songs on them that got me hyped. I wanted to get the Eminem Show because I heard Without Me. I wanted to get Joyful Rebellion by Chaos because of B-Boy Stance. And I wanted to buy I Don't Want You Back by Iman because of the song F It. Thankfully, my dad told me he was not going to get me that album when I was 13 because I know it would have been collecting dust, but those first two albums I mentioned hold up. Mostly. I was looking over my album collection that I built up since the 9th grade. They all represent an entire part of my life. They represent stages of my life that I go back on and let the memories flow when I listen to one. And today I want to talk about an album that stood out the most. On the last set of videos, I talked about an Alice in Chains album and how it was the last true grunge album. At least at the time when I did that video, I thought it did, considering that grunge went on for at least a while longer afterwards. I talked about how the band was the darkest band in the big four of grunge. As most of you know, grunge was a down and dirty music genre, and I do mean down, like talking about drug abuse, war, depression, and death. And when I mean down and dirty, I mean in utero, because holy hell, that album speaks to me on a depressing level. Despite Alice in Chains being my favorite grunge band, sometimes I just need to breathe. It's a bit overwhelming to listen to the music at times, and I need something lighter. Enter Pearl Jam. Okay, lighter in comparison. I was thinking about a topic for my video while I was on a bus, when I was reminded of not only my album collection, but a video I was watching prior to leaving the house to meet a couple of friends. How to Get Into Pearl Jam by Crash Thompson, which is a video about which albums to listen to get into this band. I recommend watching this video series that include Rush, Dark Souls, and the Red Hot Chili Peppers. The latter I have watched 8-9 times of this video. Back to Pearl Jam. I got into this band in the middle of high school, hearing songs like Even Flow and Jeremy for the first time, and I was hooked. Then when I went to college in 2009, the first album I bought during that time was a deluxe version of 10, but eventually there will be an album that would be my favorite one from 2009. Okay, my second favorite album from 2009. This album represents something personal in my life, and I mentioned this on a stream, so here's me talking about how Backspacer affected me and helped my life. I got rejected from a few colleges, and it sucked. Because, you know, sometimes you get rejected and it's like, is it something I'm doing? Am I a failure? It's like, I'm working as hard as anybody else, but am I the failure? How come I'm not as good as anybody else? But yeah, at the time I thought to myself, everybody else is doing so well. Everybody knows what they're doing. And me, I don't know what to do since high school is winding down. Yeah, I genuinely didn't know what to do. So I was just in my basement, listening to the darkest music I could think of, which was Alice in Chains. You know, just nothing but Alice in Chains and like dark music, because I didn't think I could be happy again. Because getting rejected all those times just hurt. It got to the point to where even my mom actually had to drag me out from the basement because she needed to get me out of the house. So I went shopping with her and I just dragged my feet, and then when we got back home, I just went back down to the same basement and just like stared at my TV and just did nothing for hours at a time. Just didn't take a shower, didn't really change my clothes. It was rough, you know? It was absolutely rough. A few people tried to talk to me. I didn't want to talk to any of my friends because they were all attending college and I was envious. And at Saturday school, which was Muslim school, I just put my head down and didn't talk to anybody because they were going to college, and it was just, you know, it was hard. It was just hard for me to talk to anybody because they're probably going to be like, it's only college, you'll find something, and it's like, you're just saying that because you found something and I couldn't. And it was pretty bad. I just didn't want to talk to anybody. And then, because sometimes I just wanted to wallow in that dark path. just so I could never be happy again. Just going deeper and deeper into my depression. Because I just wanted to wallow in that dark path. Just so I could never be happy again. And then a song. A light at the end of the tunnel. A flicker of light. Just a little further away from that dark tunnel. The Fixer by Pearl Jam. It was the first song I heard from Pearl Jam in a while. And I remember hearing that song for the first time. And it was something I needed. It was like the start of something good. Then I found a course in school called Acting for Voice and Camera. After an audition, I got in. And I remember the first day of school, I was on my way there. And the song I was playing on my way to my first class, The Fixer. And eventually, I bought the album Backspacer. It was just at a time in my life that I absolutely loved.
I met new people. I learned new things. I felt that I belonged. I got Backspacer a while later and it pieced together my soul. It was the most optimistic output at that point in time from a band that made 10 and verses. A band that made some of the darkest songs in recent history. Made an album that helped me emotionally. And it filled me with optimism for the future. It was what I needed, and it came at the right place, at the right time. Did I have some depressing moments after? Yes, life is filled with ups and downs. Do I yearn for the optimistic time? Not really. That time period was unexpected, but wanting to replicate it is not the best outlook. But whenever I want to listen to something that brings me hope, and looking back at the lighter part of my life, Backspacer is right there, waiting to be spun again. Thank you for tuning in for this season of videos. I hope you enjoy these videos, even if they were a little bit personal. I will be back, I hope, eventually, to make more videos. If you like this video or the other videos, please like, comment, or maybe subscribe to the channel. I will be back soon, hopefully not as long as it was between this set of videos. So, thank you and take care.